Dear students, I welcome you all on the e-learning platform of KRTIADS, BH Commerce and AM Science, popularly known as KTHM College Nashik. And this is Sanjay Rathod is here. Presently, we are talking about the essay, How Much Land Does a Man Need? So friends, in our previous videos, we talked about the author and his personal life and his works. And then the story of the essay, as the story divides into 10 divisions, and the story also opens in the late 19th century. Then we have a next point we discussed in the previous video, and that is Pehom's wish to buy 40 acres farm, and then how Pehom falls victim of a temptations, and in the end we also come to know that how greed overpowers the humanity as well as a Pehom. It means Pehom is a symbol of a whole human being. Then in an analysis of the essay, we also discussed the humble beginnings of the essay, then the temptations used in the prose, then the challenge of Bashkirs to Pehom, and a moral lesson which is taught by Tolstoy at the end of a lesson. Thereafter, we also discussed on symbols, as two symbols are used in the prose. One is a Pehom's spade and the second one is a the sun. And after the symbols, we also talked on the dangers of a greed and ambition. It comes in a in the part of a themes. And then, dear friends, right now we have the second themes of the prose, that is social class and money. When we look at the society in the 19th century of Russia, as in many places, social class had the power to dictate how someone saw themselves and what their future would hold. So working peasant Pehom longs for the status of a wealthy landowner, as greater assets will give him control over his future and help him transcend the limitations of his humble birth. Pehom's temptations are a strong motivational force in the story because the reader can easily sympathize with them. Pehom has a natural desire for independence and freedom, and actually this is a desire for all common man, and everyone wants to be independent as well as a freedom. Likewise, he also desires. As a peasant, farmer, he works constantly, but after the transformation, he becomes different than the peasant as he becomes the landowner. The rich landowners and the Bashkirs, by contrast, don't seem to work at all. It means that we come to know that two classes in the society, one is of a laborer and one is of a, owners. Once Pehom owns his land, he is free to decide how the land will be used, because now he is a, decision maker. In his first two locations, he has to negotiate with a commune in the land of the Bashkirs. He has the allure to complete independence. In the part 7 of the prose, Pehom daydreams about what he will do with the land after getting much more land from the Bashkirs as well as the chiefs, picturing himself as the ultimate authority over his own life. His progressions shows how increased social status can give a false sense of power. No amount of money can save him from death. He thinks that after having a lot of lands, everything will be changed. But what is destined, it cannot be changed. What is more, his upper class mobility comes with its own problem. After Russia abolished serfdom in 1861, peasant could own their land outright for the first time. This change led to new possibilities and unanticipated conflicts, as well as a rat race among the society, as well as the society people. Some farmers grew richer than others, and competition grew as everyone tried to earn more. Spearholm experiences a role of reversal in part 3 that demonstrates how class conflict can lead to corruptions. As he was a poor, then he advocates to the poverty, but as he gets land year after year, he changes his mentality according to the time, and he becomes completely changed man. Once he owns land, he can levy fines on neighbors grow poorer. When he owns land, he can levy fines on his neighbors when their animals wander onto his property. As Peham grows richer, his neighbors grow poorer. Peham forgets that he struggled to pay similar fines when he was a poor farmer himself. Still, he chooses profit over compassion. His neighbors openly despise him as a result, revealing another consequence of his wealth. It means that we come to know that how money changes a man. And this happens in the characters of a Peham after getting too much land. Then the last theme of the prose is divine power over human lives. It means that how divine power controls human being as well as human lives. Tolstoy converted to Christianity late in life. How much land does a man need is one of his many moral folk tales informed by the religious worldview. He uses Peham's fate to illustrate the power of spiritual forces, the inevitability of death, and the temporary nature of human achievement. The plot is set in a motion when the devil decides to wield his power over Peham. In the Christian tradition, the devil tempts humans to sin and ensures their destruction as a result. In part first, Peham believes if he has enough land and wealth, he will be too powerful to fear supernatural forces like the devil. The devil takes advantage of Peham's lack of humility by steering the narrative's events. The story implies Peham's temptations are often engineered by the devil. For instance, when the members of Peham's first commune try to buy land together in part 2, the devil makes sure they fight with one another because there is no mutual understanding between Peham and his neighbors, as well as among others. For instance, Peham confronts another topic Tolstoy often dealt with in his fiction, the nearness of death. When he negotiates with the Bashkirs for land in part 6, he tries to secure a deed, keeping the land for his family in the future. But this gesture isn't enough for him to escape his mortality. That might be the different things. And at the same night, he dreams he sees himself lying dead at the devil's feet. The dream image is an omen as both foreshadowing Peham's death and warning of a death that all humans must face. If a man tries to run after the greed, it means that the destruction is inevitable. As the last line of the story says, Peham only needs enough land for his grave, not for his satisfaction and not for his cremation. No other land can ever be truly his. It is associated with our cremation. At the time of cremation, how much land we require? Only 6 feet. But we are craving for having more and more lands with us as well as in our hands for the coming generations. Basically, we are not worried about ourselves, but we are worried about the generations It means coming generations, and in the dream of a coming generations, we have lost ourselves. The wealth Pahom gains is not his to keep either. The younger sister in part first hints at his moral vein, his moral, when she warns her wealthy elder sister that a fortune can be lost overnight. We also remember that there was a conversation between the younger sister and elder sisters. Both the sisters advocates both lifestyle, basically lifestyle of a countryside as well as a lifestyle of a urban one. Then each of Pahom's land holdings is temporary. He takes more and more risks, losing as much as he gains. Even with careful planning and forethought, Pahom doesn't always get what he wants. He moves beyond the Volga River, hoping for more land than ever, only to find most of the good farmland already gone. By the end of part 9, he realizes God may not want him to live on the Bashkir's land, and his efforts may have been in vain. Tolstoy wants readers not to put too much faith in their own accomplishments, since good luck can always be reversed. It means that Tolstoy wants to give a message to all human lives. One should maintain the peace of mind from the cradle to the grave. It means from the birth until to the death of a person. If the person finds satisfaction, then he can lead a very contented life. Otherwise, he will be a, you know, very disturbed life as well as a confused one. And so that we also should keep in mind while living our life, we must be satisfied, we must be happy, whatever the material, whatever the things we have, and we should not desire for having more things than we do not have. These were the themes which were used by Tolstoy in the present story. Dear friends, I think the story is ends here, and thank you for listening me and being with me. Stay home, stay safe, and keep learning. Thank you.